We're up, my diggers. It's an awful, wet, grey day in England. But I've just had a really good hunt. I didn't shoot an intro for this video, but I might as well shoot one now. I was out today using two detectors at the same time. Dueling detectors. One was the Mine Lab etrac, and the other one was the XP deus. And my thinking behind that was that the etrac could be hunting really deep. The deus wouldn't necessarily be hunting as deep, but it would hopefully pick out the smaller targets. And by using them both together over the same piece of land, I had the best chance of finding all sorts of good targets. And that worked very well. You'll see from the video that I actually had one of my best sessions ever. This is the time of year in England where anybody that has permission to go out detecting is detecting. Most of the crops are out, in fact all of the crops are out, although some have gone back in. The pasture's really low, and basically if you've got permission to detect, you're gonna go detecting, if you've got the time. Getting time for me has been pretty difficult lately with my work being so crazy, but hopefully as the winter draws nearer, I'll be getting a lot more hunts in, so there will be a lot more videos coming from me. Watch out for them. The settings that I used for my etrac can be found on my coin ID video. I'll put the link to that in the video description. And the settings that I was using for the majority of the hunt on the deus were sent to me by somebody called Stephen Orker. He's got a channel on YouTube. He's also known as Mr. Denari. And what I'm going to do is put a link to his video where he explains these specific settings also in the video description. Thank you very much, Stephen. It did seem to work. I don't know whether it was any better or any worse than any other deus setting, but the deus found the targets that the etrac found without any problem. So that's a good recommendation, because the way I've got the etrac set up, it finds stuff. It really finds stuff. So enough of my nonsense, let's jump into the hunt. Well, this one's reading between 89 and 91 on the deus. And 11:44 on the etrac with a lovely sweet tone. I'm guessing it's probably either a modern penny or a modern two pence, but I'm going to give it a dig and I shall let you see what it is. Let's get that camera in a little bit. Oh, ho, ho. Get in there! Look at that! Oh, ho, 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 ho. Absolutely loving it! This is not scrap metal. Look at that. 1921, George V crown. In pretty good condition. Oh, sorry, half crown. Getting myself excited here. It's a half crown. It's still a lovely big piece of silver. Well, 50% silver. 2 years earlier, it would have been sterling silver, but I'm happy with that. What a way to start the day. Ah, I'd love to find some more of these. This is an area where I don't normally hunt. I just thought I would come, dueling detectors. Two heads, better than one. Covering twice the area. Different settings on different machines. What a way to start. To be fair, any machine would have found this. You could have found this with a Garrett Ace 150. No problem at all. It's probably only 4 or 5 inches under the ground. But just look at that imprint. Absolutely lovely. I'm so pleased with that. It's been a long time since I found any fairly big silver. I've just been finding sixpences, the odd threepenny bit. I haven't even found any shillings for long enough. No florins, and then this half crown pops up. Get in there. Get in. What a way to start the day. It's probably all downhill from here, but I don't care. I'm happy with that. This is another lovely signal. I'll just mark that, get my spade, dig it up, and hopefully it'll be something else good. There's a nice bit of discoloration to the soil here. It's a very brown soil, but there is patches where it's a little bit darker, almost like ash. And that's normally a sign that there's been a coin ball. Hey up, I've dropped the probe on it. Wow, it's another coin. Not quite as spectacular as that last one, but it's another coin. It's an old penny. And whose is this one? Oh. Ooh. Well, it's quite old, 1889, makes it Queen Victoria. Oh, it's got a lot of scabbiness on it. Not sure whether you can see that very well. It's not in the best of condition. But it's another old coin, and I'm very happy with that. £11.47 on the etrac, £92 on the deus. Both of them lovely clean tones, very solid signals. So let's get it dug. Well, unfortunately, I don't think it's anything to get excited about. Looks like a big top off a jam jar or something. Yep, that's what it is. The top off a jar. It gave a beautiful signal. I was quite excited there for a minute. Now I'm really hoping this one is not another lid for a jam jar. Ooh, it isn't. It's another coin.
Oh, there's no detail on it, unfortunately. That looks like a Georgian half penny.
Now here we've got a lovely big old oak tree. I've been hunting under these for the last half an hour or so, but they're not ideal. That's not really old enough to get into the really old stuff that I'm after. I'm after Georgian stuff and possibly earlier. That is what I'm searching around. That's a huge old tree stump from a massive oak tree. That might have been cut down, I don't know, 100 years ago, maybe more. Remnants of it are still there, and that tree could have been used to have picnics under. Maybe it's back 200, 250 years ago. It was a real colossus. I'm hoping there's some stuff around these. There's quite a few of these stumps, so you never know. Something might turn up.
This is one of those ones that was reading, I think it was 1110 on the etrac. And because recently I did a video where I was testing all sorts of coins, I'm thinking to half sovereign, that's roughly where that hit half sovereign. In all likelihood, it's probably going to be half a ring pull. On the deus, it was reading about 65, 66, but it was given a lovely sweet tone. And I'm having problems finding the blooming thing. Oh my. Oh my. It's not a coin, and it most certainly isn't a gold half sovereign, but it looks like a ring. And it hits where little gold rings hit. Oh, looks like it's got a stone missing out of there. It doesn't really feel heavy enough to be gold, but that's good just to find a ring. I'm very pleased about that. I'll give it a bit of a clean up and have a look, see if there's any hallmarks. Yeah, it's more like a copper sort of a colour. Huh, it has, it's got hallmarks inside it. Why, you bugger? Quite possibly a gold ring. What a day already. Half a crown, a little gold ring, and I'll try and zoom in so you can see the hallmarks. I'm not sure how well the camera's picking that up. Oh, that seems quite clear. But that looks like 9.375. So I'm kind of presuming that 9-carat gold might be 0.375, possibly. I'm not too good on hallmarks because I don't find much gold. But I am exceptionally pleased with that. Get in. Get in! Well, if you think I get myself excited and really love metal detecting, you haven't seen anything yet. This channel intro is coming up from Bjorn, and he's actually gone so far as to get a tattoo on his shoulder, which is metal detecting related. That tattoo means a lot to him because it is symbolic of things that have happened in his life up to this point. And metal detecting was something he got into after a pretty rough spell, so he absolutely loves the hobby. He's just started a YouTube channel, so please check it out. And here is Bjorn.
Hello everyone, my name is Bjorn, I'm 21 years old and I'm from the Netherlands. I have recently started a new channel about metal detecting and collecting history related items such as plastic models that I built. I've got several Dutch spoken videos already. I will submit English subtitles as soon as possible, as I understand Dutch is very hard to understand. And speaking English is also very hard for me as well, as it is not my native language. Are you interested in the history about the Dutch, behind the Dutch? Try to check out my channel and stay tuned for the upcoming videos and subtitles, of course. And finally, I'd like to thank Pondguru for this opportunity and the viewers for your attention. And I'd like to wish you guys a nice day.
And in a future video, I'm hoping to get a good friend of mine to take his top off and show you his tattoos. At the age of, well, he's considerably older than me. I won't say his age because I don't know exactly. I won't speculate. But Davey, I want to see you with your top off and I want to video your tattoos. You know which Davey I'm talking about, Davey. You've got some awesome tattoos. He's got a lot of Celtic, Viking, all sorts of things. He's got a hoard of coins. He's got Viking longships. When I was last talking to him, he had a spare bit of space up here. He was going to get a big wolf going all the way around here. I think it was Fenrir the wolf from Norse legend. And I would love to see his tattoos when they're finished. So viewers, I really hope to be able to bring that to you one day, because he's an awesome character. Right, on with the show.
It's a bit of a tricky signal. It's reading 10-12, which is pretty much where that last beautiful target hit. See what it reads on the deus. Yeah, 56-57. Definitely a diggable target, and on the etrac, beautiful tones. Tones are a little bit mixed up and choppy on the deus. It is bouncing a little bit. It's also bouncing a little bit on the etrac. I'm predicting this one is a ring pull, but I would love to be proved wrong again. Well, I was a little bit off with a pinpoint in there. I thought that was another silver coin. It's reading in really the wrong place on the etrac, but it's an old button. Possibly silver plated, I don't know. Nice and bright, that gave a lovely signal. Definitely diggable, but it wasn't reading where silver hits. Still, first button of the day. It's reading 1340, but it's jumping up to 0640. The CO reading, that's the conductive, is pretty static. It's jumping up and down. But it's reading right at the bottom of the depth gauge on the etrac. Still, it's giving a lovely tone and it's definitely giving a diggable signal. See if I can take these earphones off, put them on the camcorder and let you listen to the deus as well. It's a lot weaker because the target is deep, but it's still pretty much diggable. Yeah, I'm not sure this is going to work. I've just put the earphones on top of the camcorder.
Hopefully it'll pick up the signal. It's weaker, but it's a repeatable signal. And it's reading 92, 93, definitely a diggable signal. It's very deep, so I'm going to go a little bit bigger with this hole, just in case I clip something and it's good. Well, it's not as deep as I thought, which makes me think it's not as big as I thought either. Oh no! My God, it was only about 4 inches deep. It's a modern penny. Gave a nice signal, but both machines thought that was deep. I wonder if there's anything else in there. Nah, that was it. Modern penny. Zero 0635 on the etrac. Reading 1237 that way. Lovely strong tone, reading 78 on the deus. 81 that way. Whichever way you look at it, or whichever way you listen to it, it's a hell of a good signal. It's getting dug. Well, I can't see anything silver or gold. But the way the day is going, this could be anything. That's a big old ring. I'll send that one down for Jed. Peace Havens, he likes the big old rings. Unfortunately, this ring isn't as good as the last one I got.
This wasn't the clearest of signals, but it looks like a little buckle. It was reading 1233 on the etrac, oh dear, and, ooh, what was it? I think 80 on the deus. Both of them gave a good signal, but it was only 3 inches down under the ground. It was a lovely clean signal. It was reading 1035 on the etrac, and I think it was 82, or maybe it was 83 on the deus. And there we've got another halfpenny. That one's in slightly better condition than the last one, although I can't see the date on it. The date will be down here. Nah, it's a little bit too worn. It's George V. Another one reading 1035, and it's another halfpenny. Whose is that one? Another George V. Yep, 1927. It's in pretty good condition. Nice patina on it as well. Lovely and green. This one was reading 1533 and 76 on the deus. It was reading more or less where the half pennies hit, but it's totally different. This isn't a half penny, and I have no idea what it is. Ah, it's a fancy leg. That would go on the bottom of maybe something like a big jewellery box or something like that. Or maybe it's a serving tray. Quite a thick serving tray though. It's quite an interesting artifact.
This one's reading very high on the etrac. It's reading 138 or 139. It's not really reading very well on the deus, which is making us think that this isn't possibly a very good target, but it's going to get dug. There's a big rock in there, it's probably the rock. Oh, get in there. I've got a big rock, but underneath that is a tiny little beautiful bit of silver.
dropped it. Just as well I saw where I dropped that, because it's absolutely tiny. Who's this? Oh! Man, hands are so mucky. Oh, it's quite worn, but that's a Edward the Seventh, 3 pence. Oh, hopefully you'll be able to see that. Ah, that's not too bad. There you go. Edward the Seventh, and that one is 1910. And I'm just trying to think when the last Edward the Seventh silver I found was. And I can't remember ever finding one. I'm gonna have to check back through my coin collection and also through my videos. But I can't recollect finding anything from Edward the Seventh apart from pennies and halfpennies. So I'm very pleased with that. Especially seeing as one detector said yes, and the other one said, meh, I'm not sure. All the other targets today, they've both said, yes, dig. So I have done, and as you see, I've made some good finds. This is the first one where one of the detectors was a little bit iffy. So, dueling detectors saves the day. Two heads are better than one.
Here we've got another very diggable signal. It's reading 1333 on the etrac. Beautiful tones. Actually, from that way, it's reading 0737. It's reading in the right part of the screen, though, and it's giving a beautiful tone. On the deus, we've got 7880, and it's giving a nice clear tone. Nice sharp tone, definitely diggable. I'm thinking it's another half penny. This ground is soaking wet. But when the ground's wet, the deep coins give a much better signal. So I don't mind getting wet knees and dirty hands if I'm digging deep, good coins. And this one seems to be pretty deep. Oh, there we go. Whose is that? It's another George V halfpenny.
That one's in pretty poor condition, but the ground is absolutely waterlogged. I'm not going to bother trying to clean that up.
Yeah, that was probably down a good 8 inches, and it still gave a really clear signal on both machines. Yeah, it's reading 8:46. Possibly something I've missed in there. I've got another bit of silver, and I'm going to bring the camera in close for this one. Don't know whose it is, so I want a close up. Right then.
Now, out of all of that filth right in the bottom of the hole, which has to be, oh man, a good 11, 12 inches down, comes another half crown, and, yep, it's definitely half crown size, so it is a half crown. My guess there was right, but it's 1908. And what I thought originally was a George V half crown, because I find loads of them, is an Edward VII. Get to the chopper! Two Edward silver coins in the space of 5 minutes. I am happy as hell with that. Look at that. Get in there.
Well, there we have it. They're the finds that matter. Little threepenny bit from Edward the Seventh, and as far as I know, that's the first Edward the Seventh silver I've found, which was swiftly followed by the second Edward the Seventh silver. That one's a half crown, still got a bit of muck on it, but it's cleaned up pretty well. It came out reasonably clean, and it's in fairly good condition. These aren't very common, so I'm exceptionally pleased with that. Very first thing that I dug was George V, half crown. Again, it's still got a bit of muck on, but it cleaned up pretty well. In good condition as well. And the last thing is this ring. Unfortunately, it's got one of the little stones missing. So in here we've got a red stone, a black one, and I presume this one would have also been red. So it's a bit of a shame that that's missing, but it's still quite a nice little artifact. And from what I can gather, it's 9-carat gold. So there's no real weight to it, and I presume possibly there's no real value to it either. But because I hardly find any rings, I really loved finding that. Excellent.
3 silver, 1 gold, 2.5 hours. An exceptional hunt. And it doesn't always happen like that. In fact, it hardly ever happens like that. I must have cashed in some serious karma points today. So I think all my hunts after this are going to be a real letdown. But I'm just going to enjoy this while it lasts, because that was a cracking hunt. Thanks very much for watching.
Well, that's it as far as this hunt goes. It was short but very, very sweet. And those tones that the etrac were given were enough to give anybody an eargasm. Beautiful. Visit my channel if you want to check out more of my detecting videos. I've got all the playlists sorted out on the channel. So there's a wealth of things on there. I'm not sure many of them have such good finds in as this video, but there's a lot of good finds on there. Please check out Stephen's channel as well, and thank you very much for watching.
Hello, this is Stephen, also known as Mr. Denari on YouTube, and I'm now offering the chance for you to join me for a day's dig on one of my permissions. I have lots of pasture in West Yorkshire, I have lots of arable on the coast in North Yorkshire, and all you have to do to qualify for that is simply subscribe to my channel. Your name could be randomly drawn and you can come with me on a day's digging. One of the people who did just that was Alex. And Alex found his first Roman coin on the day and also walked away with a hammered, a seal matrix, one or two other bits and pieces too. So you know what to do. Press that subscribe button and you could be selected to join me on one of my digs.
It's another jam jar lid. God damn.
So enough of that slammer.
That's where it was. I knew I'd found a target here somewhere.
I am happy chappy.
It means a lot to him, but basically it...
big manky lump of metal.
I'm not sure. So what I was hoping was that the etrac could be hunting deep for the really possibly
right. That'll do.
Hello. Oh, how claggy does that want to be?
Talk to me. Get to the chopper.